Before I tell you how did I make an endless runner in Pygame, I have a confession to make. It's not an endless runner.
What?
But it could be. Let me explain it. If you watch my latest videos, it's not news for you that I made a lot of assets and I created a minigame bundle with them. That you can try out for free, you know? I'm just saying. One game out of that four is this runner game. And it's not, you know, horizontal like my Dino Run reinterpretation, but rather vertical like Subway Surfer. Except you can jump. Well, I just wanted to keep it as simple as possible while making it polished and fun to play. And it's not random for reasons, but with some simple logic, it could be turned into an endless runner. So the concept behind this minigame was to reach the top of the map with this little alien while avoiding these rude signs. If you touch them, you have to start again. If you finish the run, plus 1 point for you. And thanks to my advanced version control skills, I can show this game in different stages. Cause I recorded like nothing mid-production, obviously. So I have to do it now. And just like with the other games, the first step was to create the background. I wanted it to be long, but not too much. Like if we finish it in half a minute, it's alright. It will be a long boy. For setting up the tiles, I went the old-fashioned hard way with a sprite. Cause I have like more than 1,000 hours in it, but I'm still an idiot. So here are the tiles that I just copied and pasted into the new document. What helped me the most is the correct setup of the grid, leading to easy selection making. Since I wanted 3 lanes that we can move on, the columns in the middle were made out of the road sprite. The scenery was split into 3 different parts. The starting area with a lot of trees and bushes, a lake with some fish and of course a bridge, then lastly the farm itself with the cows and some crops. At the start there's the crest saucer and at the end, the farmhouse. Just to make sense, you know. So the easiest part was drawing and setting up the tiles. But listen to me, if you use a sprite and work with tiles, be more mindful and use the method I just discovered. Instead of copy-pasting tiles, select the tile that you want to use, press Ctrl plus B, like brush, use the selection tool again, select the area that you want to paint, go back to your brush, make sure it's on pattern aligned to source, and bam, magic. Wish I knew this from the start, bruh. If you found this trick helpful, be sure to like the video. Okay, so we have a cool background. First, we need to show only the bottom and then progress to the top of this picture. Basically, we just need to add some value to its Y coordinate every cycle. Simple. The next step was adding some... You see that? You see that? Let's skip to the end. Acceleration, yeah. We always need some attention to details, right? So, what's next? Yeah, the alien sprite. It has 3 different frames and 4 altogether for a seamless animation. Whoa, look at the way he danced! Yeah, we control it now with the arrow keys or WSD. I mean, only horizontally and only for switching lanes. I'll tell you why in a second. The next step was adding some signs. And I made 2 versions to break the repetition a bit. So the reason for switching lanes over free control is that the area where the player can move is the length of 3 tiles. Let's say 3 × 24 pixels. Times the scale factor, obviously. The player rectangle and the sign rectangle in themselves are 24×24 pixels wide. Meaning we would not collide only if we align ourselves perfectly. This would cause problems, mostly in the central lane. So to avoid this, I stick with my initial idea. So now the game detects if we collide with the signs.
Bruh.
And of course, what would be game development without bugs? In this problem, I only moved the signs downwards, whom's Y coordinates were less than the screen height. Meaning I could still collide with them after we don't see them. So I fixed it. Oh yeah. And you could ask about the placement of the signs. At first, it was random, but I knew that it would cause impossible situations, so I used tile indices for this problem. The green tiles show where the signs will go. And of course, only 1 tile big gap isn't enough, so I left the player some space to move to the next lane. The game in this state wasn't really polished, I had to fix more bugs like text displaying, speed, acceleration, sign placement, so on. Let me show this version. Initially, I wanted to end the game here, but it was bland and empty. And you know, I didn't work much on this game anymore, but there's always room for improvements. Now comes the release version with my custom-made music track and sound effects. And for the sake of nostalgia, here's the Game Boy mode. So that's how I made a not so endless runner in Pygame with my own sprites, sounds and music. Let me know your opinion about this game, and if you want to try it out, you can find the link in the description. If you need a tutorial of how you can make a similar game, leave a like and tell me in the comments. And I don't have high hopes, but if any of you want to support me, you can now buy me a coffee on my new page. I would appreciate it. Next time I'll show you the second game and we're gonna shoot up some bugs. Be sure to subscribe so you won't miss it. Until next time, stay safe and take care.